Can I go? 3, 2, 1.
Hello, this is Mark from Off Grid Europe, and today we have something exciting. It's Tom, the guy standing behind our camera. He's our new content creator. Tom is going to be helping us creating podcasts where we're going to be making interviews with some really interesting people over the coming years. And we're going to basically make our format, shall we say, more professional. We're going to have infographics and all that kind of stuff. We're going to make a really good show. So Tom, over to you.
Hey, thank you, Mark, for the nice words. So I feel already really welcome at this company, but I'm just 2 weeks there, so I know nothing about it. So I take you along with me to find out what is Off-Grid all about.
Off-Grid Europe envisions a future where everybody has access to clean, reliable energy, and especially making it affordable. And we as Off-Grid Europe do that by trying to be innovative, by trying to continue improving the technology through hardware improvements and software improvements, and keep the prices but not the quality down.
Hi, I'm Damien. I handle system integration and testing at Off-Grid Europe. I'll give a walkthrough through our production here. Please excuse the mess. We're in between shipments at the moment, and it's one of the times that we're able to rearrange and reorganize things. Over there, we have a charging and discharging bench for the lithium batteries. We've just been doing testing and balancing of these before they are incorporated into our systems and shipped out. We have insulated containers here. We have our storage here. This is where the equipment will be stored and prepped before it's actually installed into the container or loaded up for dispatch. And work area for the electricians, where they're handling the larger cabinets, drilling, larger cable preparation, that sort of thing. This is an incomplete cabinet. This is handling the AC distribution out to the village. It's also got monitoring and the transfer switch, transfer control incorporated into it. Here we have Akash in the kitchen, home to our coffee machine, the most valuable employee. Here we have some new offices that used to be an R&D area, and now we have logistics, we have software development, we have our guest logistics from Senegal, Sadina. And in the corner there, we have Lemon, the office dog.
So let me give you a quick introduction to the office as well. We can't catch everybody sitting at the desk, unfortunately, right now, so a few places will be empty. Production manager is sitting here. Over there, we move on to the videographer, which is actually holding the camera right now, so he's not at his desk. Behind it, we move on to the creative department and marketing. Over here, we have communication and marketing support. Here, we have meeting desk, I guess, where people just sporadically start sitting with each other. We move on to project management and support for the sales operation. Then we have the lady who is working on the ERP system. In the far corner is accounting. That's where I sit. Let me just clean up a little bit. And yeah, normally it's very, very clean, but unfortunately you catch me right now with a bit of a messy desk. So this is our meeting room. A lot of important decisions have been taken in the past few years in this room. We had a lot of very interesting guests who came to see us. And if you want to continue meeting with us, please subscribe to our channel, and you will hear a lot more from us.
Here we have the chaos of the new R&D area. A lot of the old equipment from the other R&D area has been moved into here. Everything is still in progress here. Again, I'm saying it a lot, but please excuse the mess. But aside from all the miscellaneous components and mess, we've got a couple of systems set up here. They have a lot of people at work here. Hey guys. You know, everything that we're, all the structures that go into our systems are produced here. They're sent off for galvanizing, come back and they're shipped out. We're producing everything in-house, and it's really great that we can actually turn around designs really quickly. We can test out ideas, and we've had so many improvements over time with the design for our structure. And address so many issues. Like, you know, for as one example, we had the cross beams that support the panels. We went through about 20 revisions of the hook that they use there. And you can't do that when you just send off a design and you get 1,000 pieces back. Same thing when there is an issue, the guys are able to repair or replace parts really quickly.
My name is Jordan. I've been working at Offgrid for the last 2 months in production, and in the last month we've been starting a new project with 3D printing. This is our 3D printer room. We have here two filament printers and two resin printers. And with the printers we're able to make fast prototypes, different parts that we would otherwise have to send to China for prototyping. This allows us to in-house make quick prototypes, for example this here.
So now you have seen the German part of Offgrid Europe. In the next video, you will learn more about the Offgrid Africa operations in Senegal. And please subscribe to the channel, because then you will be informed when the next video is out. Thank you very much for watching. See you later.